Number 17, Destiny Fitzpatrick. Batting sixth, number 7, Haley Bracey. Batting seventh, number 16, Eliza Vicker. Number 19, Zoe Willis. Hitting cleanup, number 0, Caitlin Wood. Batting fifth, number 32, Haley Panette. Batting sixth, number 23, Natalia Herrera. Batting seventh, number 25, Ashlyn Rogers. Batting eighth, number 30, Ansley Duffy. And your flex for tonight is number 24, Henderson Hurdle. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we play our national anthem.
Coming to the plate, number 42, Michaela Cruz.
Welcome everybody joining us here in game one of our doubleheader, Fort Valley State taking on the Hurricanes. Zoe Willis will be the starting pitcher for the Canes. It'll be Cruz batting. Zoe Willis has had a great season. She's at a 2.64 ERA. This is her ninth start. First pitch, be a swing and a miss, 0-1. Good day today, sun's out. I think it's pitch go ball, 1-1 now. Cruz on the season for Fort Valley is having a good season. She's at 333 as Willis pitches ball two. It's going to go high. It makes it 3-1 now. Willis behind early, but she's a great pitcher. She'll get out of it.
3-1. And Willis is going to walk the first batter, Cruz.
Now batting number three, Mariah Williams.
So after Willis issued the pass, Fort Valley State is a runner at first. In the plate would be Mariah Williams. Mariah Williams leads the team. She's hitting 400. Going for a steal attempt, but she's going to lay down a bunt. They'll get the out at first. One out.
Now batting number 22, Raven Webb.
So after the bunt attempt, Fort Valley now has a runner at second. One out. Brings up Raven Webb to the plate. She's second on the team. She's hitting 364. First pitch. That's going to be a ball, 1-0. Wildcats threatening here in the top of the first. That's going to be a called strike, make it 1-1. So we got a bunch of ones. 1-1 count, one out in the top of the first. It's going to be a ball, makes it 2-1. Yeah, Willis coming in, and she's had a great year. She's a great two-way player, both at the bat and in pitching. Very solid season. Swing and a miss. It'll even account at 2 apiece. Willis looking to pitch out of the jam here. That's going to be put in play.
Now batting number 21, Layla Leverett.
Yeah, Rutledge just made a good throw to get that runner out. So bring up Leverett to the plate. Third on a team hitting 362. Well, three out of their first four hitters are at 333 or better. First pitch is a called strike, 0-1. We have two outs here at the top of the first. Pitch. That's going to be a ball to even the count at 1. Willis trying to work out of the jam here. Runners at second for Fort Valley. Now it'll be a swing and strike, 1-2. We got a 1-2 pitch. Willis looking to get out of the inning. Two outs. And the 1-2 pitch. That's going to go foul. Count will remain 1-2. The Canes are looking to bounce back. They were swept by North Georgia, but North Georgia is a very good team, number one in the country. And two of the games, the Canes had them on the ropes. So Canes are a very solid team this season. Now it'll be a strikeout from Willis, and that'll be the end of the inning. Fort Valley State leaves a runner at first. We go to the bottom of the first. Go ahead, take a look at the replay on the... Thank you. was a pitch from Willis. I'm surprised she swung at something that high, but it worked out for Willis. She did a good job getting out of the jam. Welcome back. We're going to start the bottom of the first. Be Kimmy Singer to lead it off today for the Canes. Coming in, having a good season, hitting 346. Pitching for Fort Valley's number 34, Caprice Johnson. Johnson, pretty solid season, 365 ERA. It's going to be a ball. Makes the count 1-0. So you want for your leadoff hitter hitting 346. It's going to be another ball. It makes it count 2-0, so Singer's ahead now. That's going to be a called strike, 2-1. Gives a 2-1 to Singer. That's going to be a ball. Make the count 3-1. See if Singer can get on base here on 3-1 count. And the pitch. That's going to go foul. Make the count full. We got a full count to Singer. No outs here in the bottom of the first. That's going to be put in play. She's just going to get a single that goes towards center field. So that'll be the Canes' first hit.
Now batting, number 7, Lacey Rutledge.
So after the single from Singer, Canes have a runner at first, bring up Lacey Rutledge. Rutledge is having a good season as well. She's hitting 333. Here comes Singer with the steal. And that'll be her lucky 13th steal of the season. Pitches a ball, so 1-0 count to Rutledge. Singer's going to, she thought about going again. It's going to be an out on Rutledge. Singer will stay at second.
Now batting, number 19, Zoe Willis.
To bring up Willis, who's starting today's game as a pitcher. She's at 481. Singer thought about going to third, but goes back and 1-0 pitch. Yeah, Singer's only been caught once this season. There's a good steal percentage. It's going to be a called strike. Even the count at 1 apiece. Because I know Singer's been flirting with the idea of going to third the last two pitches. And Willis, that's going to be hit to left field. She'll grab a single. Willis will go to third and stay there. So two hits now for the Canes.
Now batting number 0, Caitlin Wood.
Runners in the corners now for GSW. Brings up Wood. She's in the 400s, too. She's hitting 422 on the season, second on the team, behind Willis, who just got the single. Willis is going to go to second for the steal attempt. And she's in there safely. So we have a 1-0 count the wood now after the steal from Willis. It's a smart play there and avoid the double play. That's going to right to second. She's going to go to third. And then Singer's going to come home, so that'll be a run for the Canes. They lead 1-0 here now. Now batting number 32, Haley Panette. So two outs here. Canes have two hits. The bottom of the first and Willis at second base. This is Panette now. That pitch is in the dirt. That'll be a ball, 1-0. It's going to be right to the second baseman, but the Canes do get two hits. They score a run, and they leave a runner on base. As we go to the top of the second, Canes lead 1-0. Welcome back. We start at the top of the second. Canes lead 1-0. So bring up Destiny Fitzpatrick for Fort Valley State. Fitzpatrick coming in, is hitting 310. Pretty good. Here comes the first pitch of the at bat. That'll be a ball, makes it 1-0. Here comes a 1-0 pitch from Willis. That's going to be a called strike that'll even the count at one apiece. Here's the pitch. That's going to be a foul. A ball will go count be 1-2 now. So Willis has worked a 1-2 count on Fitzpatrick. And Willis strikes out Fitzpatrick. That'll be the first out of the inning. Now batting number 7, Haley Bracey. After the strikeout, Haley Bracey would be at the plate for the Wildcats. Hitting 200 on the year. Looking to improve upon that. First pitch is a called strike, 0-1. Going to take a look at the last strikeout from Willis. The same thing. He got on another high, hard one. It's going to be a ball, even to count at one apiece. Stop That's going to be a called strike. It'll be 1-2. So Willis now ahead against Bracey. And that's going to be a called strike. So Willis gets her second strike out of the inning.
Now batting number 16, Alisa Vickers.
So bring up Alisa Vickers. Now hitting 262 on the season. Willis so far has struck out both batters and start the inning. First pitch is a called strike, 0-1. It was a called strike. That'll be a swing and a miss, 0-2 now. So Will was looking here to strike out the side. And she does, so she'll strike out the side. So we go to the bottom of the second. Canes lead 1-0. This will be Herrera's 8th start of the season. Pitch. It's a ball 1-0. Herrera's at 211, but she's a much better hitter than that. I'm sure she's looking to improve upon that. That's going to be to right field. That'll be a single for Herrera.
Now batting number 25, Ashlyn Rogers.
Oh, wait, she's going to second. So Herrera goes to second. So now, after the steal there, Herrera's at second base. You got Rogers at the plate. Rogers playing first base today, usually catching. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. Wonder if Herrera is going to flirt with the idea of stealing third. That's going to go past the third baseman. So Rogers will get a single.
Now batting number 30, Ansley Duffy.
This brings up Duffy. Canes have runners at the corners. No outs here in the bottom of the second. As they lead 1-0. Duffy on the air sitting 283. going to be, they get the runner at second, but Duffy's going to be safe at first, and Herrera will come home, be 2-0 Canes now.
Now batting number one, J.C. Johns.
So they get, after getting the force at second, Canes are runner at first here, Johns at the plate. They lead 2-0. It's going to be a called strike, 0-1. The 0-1 pitch, that's going to go foul, makes it 0-2. So John's behind here, 0-2 in the at-bat. That'll be a ball, makes it 1-2 now. So here comes the 1-2 pitch now. It's going to go to the pitcher. She's going to throw to first, but no play at second. So two outs now.
Now batting number 22, Kimmy Singer.
So the Canes have batted around the lineup. This will be Singer's second appearance of the game. Canes have a runner at second. They've already scored a run in this inning. They have 2-0. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. That'll be a called strike. That'll even count at 1-1 to Singer now. That's going to go right back to the pitcher, and that'll be the final out of the inning, but the Canes do score a run, get a hit, they leave a runner on. We go to the top of the third, Canes lead 2-0. Taking a look at the press box here, the great staff here in the box making everything go smoothly.
Now batting number 11, Tiffany Rose.
Welcome back. Start. Top of the third will be Tiffany Rose at a plate for the Wildcats. Canes lead 2-0. First pitch is a swing and strike, 0-1. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. That'll be another swing and a miss. Be 0-2 now. Last inning, Willis struck out the side. Pitch. That's going to be a They're going to decide if she swung, but apparently she didn't, so it'll be a 1-2 pitch now, 1-2 count now. Here's the 1-2 pitch. And that'll be a strikeout from Willis. First out of the inning.
It was a swing and a miss.
Now batting number 23, Riley Jenkins. So this will bring up Jenkins for Wildcats. First pitch goes foul. Go 0-1 now. Jenkins coming in. You have to take a look at the last strikeout here from Willis. Again, she keeps getting all these batters high. So we have an 0-1 count now. That'll be a ball and even a count at one apiece. Jenkins coming in was hitting 158. That'll be a swing and a miss. Makes it 1-2 now. So Willis struck out the last batter, and she struck out the side the previous inning. That's going to be put in play, but Singer out of left is able to get it, so it'll be the second out of the inning. Now batting number 42, Michaela Cruz. The Wildcats have batted around in their order. Bring up the leadoff hitter, Cruz. First pitch is a called strike, 0-1. Kings lead 2-0 here in the top of the third. With two outs. That's going to go foul, make the count 0-2. So Willis is ahead here, 0-2. That'll be a ball, makes it 1-2. Willis looking to get out of the inning here, hopefully a first strikeout. That'll be a ball to even count at 2. We have a 2-2 count here. That's going to be a call strike, so Willis will strike her out. As we go to the bottom of the third, Canes lead 2-0. Going to take a look at the strikeout here from Willis on instant replay. That was a good pitch. That one was more towards the middle because she's been getting all their batters high today. 2-0 here. Got 4 hits on the day. First pitch to roll, which is a college strike, 0-1. That'll be a ball to even count at 1 apiece. This is going to go past the second baseman there, so Rutledge will get a credit for a single here. Canes have a runner on now. Now batting number 19, Zoe Willis. So that'll bring Willis to the plate after the single from Rutledge. Rutledge can steal a bag or two. She has 4 on the season. She flirted with the idea, but didn't go. First pitch is a ball. It'll be 1-0. And Rutledge is going to steal. She gets there in time, so that'll be a steal for Rutledge. I didn't see. I was looking at the steal. I didn't see what she did. I think so, too. I think it's 2-0. So we'll also work a 2-out count after the steal from Rutledge. That'll be a called strike, 2-1 now. Johnson looking to throw her. That's going to go foul, even account at 2 apiece. So no outs here in the bottom of the third. Canes are threatening with a runner at second.
This is the center hit for the infield.
Going to go bounce in front of the left fielder. That'll be a hit for Willis. Now batting number 0, Caitlin Wood. That'll bring up Wood with runners at the corners for the Canes. Willis does have a steal already in this game, so she is a threat to go. Johnson looking to see what she wants to throw Wood. And Wood thought about laying down. Willis is going to go to second. So there was a called strike, and Willis to get the steal. So runners at second and third now. Willis' second steal of the day. Canes, they've just been timing their jumps perfectly for the steals. Be a ball, even the count at 1. Second and third, no outs. Canes have a 2-0 lead. That's going to go towards right center. Rutledge will come home. Willis is going to come home, and that will be a double for Wood. Canes now lead 4-0. Now batting 32, Haley Panette. So after the 2-RBI double from Wood, brings up Panette now. Johnson looking to see which one to throw Panette in the first pitch. Going to go to the shortstop. She'll go to Fitzpatrick at first. That'll be the first out for the Canes in the inning.
Now batting number 23, Natalia Herrera.
So bring up Herrera now. Getting the start today. Kings have already scored two, but they are threatening. They have Wood at second. First pitch is a ball, makes it 1-0. That'll be a swing and a miss, make even up the count at one apiece. So the Kings threatening. They've already scored two in the inning. Runner at second with one out. Here in the bottom of the third. That's going to go right to the pitcher, Johnson. She'll go to Fitzpatrick for the second out, but was able to go to third.
Now batting number 25, Ashlyn Rogers.
So bring up Rogers playing first base today. Kings have a runner at third, two outs. That's going to be put in play, but it looks like the second baseman is going to grab it, and that'll be the end of the inning. But the Canes do score two runs, and they leave a runner on. You go to the top of the fourth, 4-0 Canes. Go ahead and take a look at the two RBI double from Wood on their replay. It was a good hit right between right and center field. A tough play for them. Welcome back. Start at the top of the fourth. Canes have a 4-0 lead. Will is pitching a great game for the Canes today. This will be Mariah Williams at the plate for Fort Valley State. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. So Willis looking to see what she wants to throw. And the 1-0 pitch. He's going to lay down a bunt. That's going to go foul, even the count at one apiece. I don't know why you bunt in the situation. You're down four runs. I guess to maybe get someone on base for momentum, but. That's going to go just out of the reach of Singer left. That's going to go foul. Makes the count 1-2. So Willis has worked a 1-2 count here. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. That'll be a ball. That'll even the count at two apiece. Here's the 2-2 pitch. That'll be a strikeout. Be the first out of the inning.
Now batting number 22, Raven Webb.
Let's bring up. She like half swung on it. I would have done it as a swing in, but. First pitch is a ball, 1-0.
I would have done that too, because it's like a half swing. Yeah.
So we got one out here at the top of the fourth. Canes lead 4-0. That's going to be a ball. Makes it 2-0 now. That'll be a ball. Makes it 3-0. Willis behind here. The batter, Webb, came in second on the team before Valley State at average. He was at 364. Mound visit here. Duffy talking to Willis. So Willis behind 3-0 here. That's going to be a called strike, be 3-1. See if Willis can work out of the 3-0 jam. And the count will go full, so Willis now makes the count full after the foul. We get a full count to the batter, Raven Webb, with one out here at the top of the fourth. Willis. That's going to go foul. Count will remain 3-2. Switching out balls here. So Willis was behind 3-0, but she's worked her way back to a 3-2 count. The pitch. That's going to be a walk. So now Fort Valley State is our runner at first base.
Now batting number 21, Layla Leverett.
It's a pinch runner for, I think it's one. Be Jones.
Pinch running for the Wildcats, number one, Andira Jones.
So the. The Wildcats brought in the pinch runner. It'll be Jones at first base now after the walk. And you have Leverett at the plate. Pitch. It's a called strike, the 0-1. Here's the 0-1 pitch. That's going to go foul. Makes it 0-2. So Willis has worked the 0-2 count here. After the walk. That'll be a ball. Makes it count 1-2. Deliberate was third on the team coming in. She's at 362. That'll be a ball that even counted two apiece. I'm curious if they're going to send Jones because she was the pinch runner. That'll be a swing and a miss. Be a strikeout for Willis there. Two outs now in the inning. Now batting number 17, Destiny Fitzpatrick. So bring up Fitzpatrick for the Wildcats. After the strikeout from Willis. Pitch. Jones is going to try to steal second. She gets there in time. The throw was a little off, so she'll get a steal. So after the steal, it's a 1-0 count now. Swing and a miss, even a count at one apiece. Yeah, I was wondering if they would send Jones because she was flirting with the idea of going to second the whole at bat. And finally did. Yes, another swing and a miss. 1-2 now. So two outs. Top of the fourth. Canes have a 4-0 lead. Wildcats have a runner at second. Pitch. That'll be a strikeout from Willis. So the Wildcats leave one runner on base. No runs, no hits. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Canes lead 4-0.
They say college is the best time of your life, but what about what comes next? At Georgia Southwestern State University, you're not just here for the clubs, or the campus, or the dining hall. You're here for small class sizes, affordable programs, and real-world experience. When you come to GSW, you're not just here for college, you're here for your tomorrow. Georgia Southwestern State University, take tomorrow by storm. Start your journey at gsw.edu.
Pitch will be a ball, 1-0. Kings today have 7 hits on the 4 runs. And Willis has pitched a great game at this point. That'll be a ball. Makes the count 2-0 now. I don't know how long the Wildcats are going to keep Johnson in the game. It's going to go foul, make the count 2-1. So Duffy's worked a 2-1 count here. That's going to be going to the second baseman. She'll throw to first for the out.
Now batting number one, J.C. Johns.
The last play went Rose to Fitzpatrick. That was a good scoop and throw from Rose. It'll be Johns at a plate for the Canes. It'll be a ball for the first pitch, 1-0. So Johns looking to get some momentum. Came in hitting not very well, but she's a much better hitter. That's going to go. Shortstop's going to be able to grab it, but she make the throw. So Johns is able to beat the throw, so that'll be a single for Johns.
Now batting number 22, Kimmy Singer.
So we bring Singer to the plate after the single from Johns. The Canes have a runner first, one out, bottom of the fourth, and they lead 4-0. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. Wondering if they're going to send Johns here. And they do. Johns will get the steal. She'll get in safely there.
The strike.
So after the steal, it's a 1-1 to Singer now. Up 2-0 and not 1-1. She's going to go to third for another steal, and she steals third base. So that's two straight steals from Johns in the at-bat, and Singer's worked a 3-0 count. Singer thought about laying down a bunt, but it'll be a strike, 3-1. And Singer will draw a walk.
Now batting number 7, Lacey Rutledge.
So runners in the corners after the walk from Singer, 1-0. Bring up Lacey Rutledge. And now Singer's going to go over to second, and she'll get there in time for the steal.
It was looking.
So the 0-1 now. It's going to put in play. Singer's going to try to go home. So Rutledge scores. I'm sorry, John scores. So that'll be 5-0 Canes now.
Now batting number 19, Zoe Willis.
We have two outs here. Bottom of the fourth. Canes have already scored. They lead 5-0. First pitch is a called strike, 0-1.
Called strike.
That'll be a ball, even to count at one apiece. 20. The Canes have really ran the bases well today. That'll be a ball. Makes it count 2-1. Kane's looking to add to the lead here in the inning. Willis is going to get the single to go to center. She's going to try for two for the double, and she gets the double. As Singer comes home, so it's 6-0 Canes now. Now batting number 0, Caitlin Wood. Wood at the plate. First pitch to Wood. It's going to go to the shortstop, and she'll get him out. But the Canes do score 2 runs here as we go top of the 5th. Canes lead 6-0. Go ahead and take a look at the double from Willis. And here's Willis's double. Put it in a good spot, right at center field. She was able to hustle the second. It's a good play for the RBI double. Cats. Willis is throwing 4 scoreless innings. A pitch. That'll be a ball. Makes it count 1-0. So Willis, 1-0 pitch. Be a swing and miss, 1-1 now. Willis has looked sharp today on pitching. That'd be a called strike, 1-2 now. Willis can keep this up here in the 5th inning. She's on 4 scoreless. That's going to go left field. That'll be Singer to grab it. Be the first out of the inning.
Now batting number 16, Alicia Bickers.
And 1 out here in the 5th. We have Vickers the plate for the Wildcats. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. Swing and a miss, and even a count at 1 apiece. 1 out here in the top of the 5th. The 1-1 pitch. And she's going to get plunked, and that'll put her at first base.
She had already walked a couple already. Now batting number 11, Tiffany Rose.
So after Vickers was hit, Wildcats have a runner at first, one out. That'll be a ball 1-0 now. Time is called the visit. The Canes, they have looked sharp on all facets of the game. They've been hitting well. They've been, Willis has been pitching great, and they've been stealing all. I think after the game, they need to change their name to the Steelers, but spell it S-T-A-L. The 1-0 pitch. He's swinging and miss, 1-1 now. That'll be a swing and a miss, 1-2 now. So Willis has worked a 1-2 pitch. And Willis will strike her out. That'll be the second out of the inning.
Now batting number 23, Riley Jenkins.
After the strikeout, brings up Jenkins to the plate. Wildcats have a runner on first. It's going to be put in play. That's going to go over the head of Singer. That'll be a double for Jenkins. So second and third now for the Wildcats. Damn, she lost a no-hitter.
Now batting number 42, Michaela Cruz.
That was a strikeout pitch before they lost a no hitter.
Pinch runner now at second, number two. Pinch running for the Wildcats, number two, Taylor Watson.
She's at second as the pinch runner. So the Wildcats have brought in a pinch runner. They have runners at second and third, two outs. And Zoe Willis just lost a no-hitter, but she's been pitching great regardless. First pitch is a ball, makes it 1-0. I'll be a swing and a miss, evens the count at one. So the 1-1 to Cruz. I'll be a swing and a miss, 1-2 now. Wildcats are threatening. Runners at second and third. Be a ball even to count it to. It's a 2-2 count to Cruz. It's going to go foul, count to remain even at two. Canes lead 6-0 here in the top of the fifth. Getting some new balls here. Breaking the action. So It's a 2-2 to Cruz with two outs here at the top of the fifth. That'll be a strikeout from Willis. Well, the Wildcats leave two runners on. They get a hit, and the Canes lead 6-0 as you go to the bottom of the fifth. We're going to take a look at the strikeout, the end of the inning here from Willis. Another high one. Good. She's been getting a lot of their batters high in the zone today.
Belts and hoses, not X and O's. I do owe two sensors, but not defenses. Yeah, I make a right call to keep your car in the game. Don't even need a playbook, it's all in my brain. Fuel injectors, alternators, radiators too. It's who I am, it's what I do.
Now batting for the Hurricanes, number 32.
Welcome back. So there's been changes made for the Wildcats here. Pitching will be number 22, Raven Webb. So Caprice Johnson's day is done. Bring up Panette for the Canes. Called strike, 0-1 to Panette. The Canes have mustered 9 hits today and have been stealing bases all over the yard. There'll be another called strike, 0-2. They count to Panette now.
Third baseman's new, shortstop new, second baseman's new.
Yeah, I think so. And here's the pitch. That's going to go right to center field. So that'll be a single for Panette. Now batting number 23, Natalia Herrera. So it brings up Herrera after the Panette single. I wonder if they're going to send Panette. Why not? They've been stealing great all game. Pitch be high, 1-0 now. So we have 1-0 to Herrera. The pitch from Webb. And Panette was going to steal. Oh, center fielder drops it. So Panette will go to third, and now Herrera goes to second. Now batting number 25, Ashlyn Rogers. So Kane's threatening again here. Runners to second and third. Brings up Rogers to the plate. Got a visitor from the coach of the Wildcats. I don't think they're going to pull her just yet. And yeah, it was just a conversation. Okay. So go. About to go the first pitch to Rogers. Thought about laying down a bunt, but it goes foul, 0-1. Kane's second and third, no outs here in the bottom of the fifth as they lead 6-0. That'll be a ball, even to count at one apiece. Webb looking at the wristband, see what she wants to throw to Rogers. Rogers is going to swing. That's going to go past the shortstop. Panette will come home. He's 7-0 Canes now. Now batting number 30, Ansley Duffy. Brings up Duffy. The Canes have scored here. Now lead 7-0. Runners at the corners, no outs. So pinch, okay, three. Pinch running for the Hurricanes. Number three, Bailey Christian. So after the single from Rogers, they're going to pinch runner. It'll be Bailey Christian. Thought about laying about. Christian's going to go to second. No throw. That'll be a steal. Christian. Going to 0-1 to Duffy. Be a ball, even to count at one. Reminds me of a game in the majors. I think it's like 10 years ago. It was a Pirates and Brewers game. Brewers had 7 steals on there on them. I don't know how many we have. But I think we're close to that. A pitch. That's gonna go. You're gonna throw home. The catcher can't grab it, so Herrera's gonna be safe at home. 8-0 Canes now. And that'll be the end of the game as the Canes win 8-0 here in game one.
Canes win. Canes win 8-0.